Hi, and welcome back to this second Repro-5 tutorial. I'm going to start with the init preset, as usual. Then turn down oscillator B in the mixer, so we're only hearing oscillator A. Then I'll turn on the oscillator A frequency destination in the wheel modulation section, and push up the mod wheel. And oscillator A now sweeps up and down in pitch, as it's being modulated by the LFO. Now let's crossfade to the noise source instead of the LFO. And the sound becomes chaotic and noisy. Modulating parameters with a touch of noise can be a useful alternative to adding noise in the mixer, with quite different results. But I have something else in mind. I'm going to switch to the iCandy tweaks page and find the little jumper switch marked S and H, which stands for sample and hold. The noise source is now sampled once every LFO cycle, and that value is held until the LFO restarts again. So the result is a stream of random values at regular intervals clocked by the LFO. Now let's tune the oscillator up a couple of octaves and sync it to oscillator B. And those pitch offsets turn into tonal changes. Let's tempo sync the LFO and set it to 16th notes. Now I'll wind down the filter cutoff and add some resonance and dial in some envelope modulation for the filter with a slow attack and decay and sustain all the way down so that the filter swells open then closes again for each chord. And let's also modulate the filter with the sample and hold LFO. And I can now use the mod wheel to control the level of both the oscillator A pitch modulation and the filter modulation. Now let's switch to the effects tab and dial in some polyphonic distortion. Switching to hard clipping gives us a brighter, more aggressive type of distortion, though you can still use this subtly if you set the amount knob carefully. This can make the signal simultaneously fatter and brighter, and probably also louder, so you may need to drop the output level to compensate. Moving to the right, let's soften the sound with a bit of reverb. And I've yet to find a sound that can't benefit from a touch of velvet, which I'll try at the end of the chain. As a final touch, I'll switch to the tweaks page again, where we see a row of LEDs telling us which voices are active, and a corresponding row of trim pots, which allow us to pan each individual voice left or right. If I pan them all alternately hard left and hard right, I can create a cool pseudo stereo effect when playing chords. Notice, however, if I play the same note repeatedly, Repro-5 will reuse the same voice each time. It might be better to switch the voice allocation jumper to the left. And Repro-5 will now step through the voices, and each note will be panned alternately left and right. Okay, let's try another example. I'll start by turning oscillator B all the way down again. And I'll set oscillator A to a square wave. I want this to respond like a monosynth, so I'll drop the number of voices to 1. And I can now dial in a touch of glide to make notes swoop up or down instead of changing pitch instantly. Now I'm going to close down the filter and wind in some resonance, and add a little touch of envelope modulation to create a subtle wow articulation for each note. But for the purposes I have in mind, we need to keep this pretty subtle and avoid opening the filter too wide. Now I'm going to switch oscillator B to the triangle wave, turn off key tracking so it runs at a constant frequency whatever note I play, and switch it to low frequency mode. And this oscillator now behaves like an LFO. Let's turn on the filter destination in the voice modulation section and turn up the oscillator B source so that it starts to modulate the filter. But again, I want to keep this pretty subtle. Now let's make this modulation more complex and less predictable by modulating the frequency of oscillator B with the LFO. We now have a bass sound with slightly unpredictable filter modulation. But the lack of high frequency content makes it sound rather soft and warm. So let's turn to the polyphonic distortion section again. And this time I'll pick the corrode type, which provides a very digital sounding sample rate reduction and bit crushing. If I reduce the sample rate with the rate knob, we start to get aliasing, where content higher than half the sample rate starts to fold back down to lower frequencies. This adds some nice gritty filth. But if you set the rate appropriately, you can get those reflected harmonics to create lovely vowel-type sounds. You can create variations of this basic sound by switching the filter type in the tweaks page. The default poly type is modelled on the filter from the polyphonic hardware synth, while the other three are based on the mono synth that inspired Repro-5. But note that the poly filter cutoff is much lower than the others, so you'll need to adjust this to compensate. While we're here, let's set the pitch bend range, an option which is moved from the front panel in Repro-5. And also switch the jumper in the mixer section to feedback instead of noise. If I switch back to the front panel, the third knob in the mixer now controls feedback, which makes the sound thicker and fatter. And also tames the resonance slightly, so you can set it a bit higher before it starts to self-oscillate. Subtle changes to the sample rate make quite a big difference to this sound. So I'm going to pick the filter envelope for a modulation slot and link it to the rate knob. But I'm only going to modulate this a tiny bit, so we stay within our vowel sound range. Let's bypass the distortion to remind ourselves what we started with. And what a big difference the distortion makes. Thanks for watching.